Doc, why do I feel pain? Believe it or not, this is a very complex question. Experiencing pain is a very important way for animals to prevent further injury. We know that putting our hand in a fire will result in a burn, but knowing this and actually experiencing the effect of putting your hand into a fire is different. Pain is the result of our body signaling to our command center, the brain, that there is a threat to our integrity. This immediate feedback prevents further damage. Pain can signal an injury to many parts of the body. With this feedback, the body initiates a line of defense to protect itself. That's why when injured, we limp, we avoid certain movements, we slow down. If we survive the injury, the affected body part needs to be shielded from extra stress while it heals. Pain signals changes to the body. Pain is an important part of our defense mechanism. It is a monitoring system. While the experience is not pleasant, without pain, we can unintentionally harm ourselves further. Unfortunately, there are some people who don't have the ability to feel pain. As expected, this often results in them sustaining more serious injuries. For example, people with advanced diabetes can lose their ability to feel pain in their legs. Because they cannot register this pain, these people can develop infections or destroy their bones and joints in their feet without even realizing it. However, pain is not always beneficial. But before we dive into cases where it can be associated with harmful effects, you need to know the two main types of pain. The pain signaling associated with warning and protecting the body are acute pain signals. They are immediate. The pain signals that can be associated with side effects are chronic pain, which can be defined as a constant pain signal that lasts for more than 3 months. Chronic pain has bad effects on your body. It is commonly associated with elevated blood pressure and poor mental health. People with chronic pain have higher rates of depression. Each person experiences depression differently. It doesn't mean someone's always crying. Depression can cause anger issues and withdrawal from society. Depression is also associated with prolonged medical problems. For those in chronic pain, it can be associated with reduced quality of your overall function over time. Chronic pain has been associated with decreased immune function. In other words, it can make you more susceptible to infection. Chronic pain can reduce activity levels. This in turn can cause deconditioning and obesity. Unfortunately for people with chronic pain, great effort must be made to continue to exercise, engage socially, maintain a healthy lifestyle, and have a positive outlook despite the pain. If the side effects of chronic pain start to appear, it can easily lead to a snowball effect, spiraling down a path of less function, more pain, and more dependency. Acute pain has its role. Chronic pain can be destructive. If you have chronic pain, make sure to explore the potential causes of this pain. If the cause can be eliminated, that's great and should be done as quickly as possible. If the cause is something that can't be avoided, like aging, genetics, trauma, then please seek the counseling of your doctor so you can learn to manage your chronic pain and avoid some of these concerns. You should now understand the difference between acute and chronic pains. Thanks for watching.